this very interesting, exciting, and I think novel concept assemblage for the National Museum of Toy and Miniatures. It's called the Toytisserie, and it's like a giant barber's pole. It's about 25 feet high, and the ribbon, it's a metal ribbon that wraps around a giant pole, and it's 150 feet long. And we are attaching all these toys which were donated. The museum asked the community to donate used and loved toys, and we're attaching them to this metal ribbon using magnets, which is like taking fridge magnets to a whole new art form level, because you get to just place and position wherever you want the toys, which I actually really like, because often when I'm doing my collage creations, I'll put something, I generally work on a horizontal, which most people do, with three-dimensional objects, but you obviously they'd be on the vertical, but you don't know until the very end where everything should be. So when you have got such a long canvas, 150 feet, as I say, it's nice to be able to be so flexible. And I'm a great one until like the very last minute, I might go, oh, no, I think this mouse should be just down here so we can just scooch him around there at the last minute. I like to keep my options open. So it is actually a really fun, I guess you would call it medium, working with the magnets to work in. Mm. My son is not too amused about it. He's 6 years old, and I drop him off at school in the mornings, and he says, it's not fair, Mummy. I have to go to school, and you go to work and play with toys all day. So he's right. I do. I'm very lucky. It's quite an unusual job, especially for a grown-up.